Scout Cadet Saifullah Daoud.
Where is my beloved land? Who snatched its happiness? Who destroyed its beauty? Who burnt its charmness? Its atmosphere turned black. Its air smells sour of bullets and tear gases. Land turned into burial places. No space left to roam freely. Desiccated, fallen chinar leaves divulges as if someone destroyed their greenery. Where is my Kashmir? Kashmir, the land of valleys, a living tear on the face of eternity, a master stroke of the omnific, the land of talking springs, chanting birds, lush green velvet fields, a paragon of beauty, honor, legend, plundered, obliterated, bleeding for 70 years, asks questions from the state holders of world peace that why they have turned a jaundiced eye to this lively hammer issue of Kashmir. Mr. President, Kashmir is a place where humanity bows its head in shame after seeing the inhuman acts of barbarism. Kashmir is the place where butchery of innocent Kashmiris is a fun for Western media as they make videos of dying, fluttering bodies. Kashmir is the place where the law of jungle applies and the mightiest has the right to survive. Kashmir is the place where blood of innocent Kashmiris scream aloud and ask the so-called stakeholders of world peace that why you have become blind. Are you a mere spectator or a promoter of violence and terrorism? Oh God, Kashmir is burning where the candle of independence is alive on the cost of 1 lakh Kashmiri martyrs. Oh God, Kashmir is burning where chastities of Kashmiri daughters are molested, but no heart bleeds. Oh God, Kashmir is burning where congregations of funerals are destined in the destiny of poor Kashmiris. Oh God, Kashmir is burning where children are raised on the lullabies of machine guns. Oh God, Kashmir is burning where girls do their makeup with pellet guns on their faces. Oh God, Kashmir is burning where young and old look towards heaven waiting for divine help but no miracle happens. Oh God, Kashmir is burning. What? Not, oh heavens, rest me off my senses. As my tongue moves on the thorns, my heart rips apart as I see the scenes of misery and helplessness. Mr. President, when an Indian soldier kills innocent Kashmiris, it's a wooden matter. But when a Kashmiri kills Indian soldier, then some national media moves heaven and earth. It tags them militant, terrorist, extremist. What? An open contradiction. Sometimes I wonder at the hypocritic role of UNO. It's quite active against the Muslim countries, but what a blind eye they have turned to the terrorist activities of Israel and America. 70 years have passed. Where is the Commission of Human Rights of UNO? Sleeping? Huh? Don't they consider the genocide of Kashmiris and Palestinian humans? Why is this partiality being done only to the Muslims? Or the so-called UNO serves the purpose of D8. But wait. I'm not hopeless. I'm not frustrated about the destiny of Kashmir because Phoenix rises from its ashes after 500 years. Freedom fighters like Burhan Wani's a beam of hope. And that day is not far, when a crop that is watered with blood bring the spring of independence.